Hey, Donald Trump has been fun to watch, hasn't he? Boy, he really lightened up the campaign. But no, whatever you think about Donald Trump, you know, is, God, I think he just has a lot to teach the rest of us, you know, about what's going on in our life today. You know, you may think he's a, you know, a sexist, racist windbag, but gosh, he really is using the current system like all the new entrepreneurs are in our economy. The world has changed. It's a whole new ball game out there. And see, if you watch his campaign, he epitomizes what's really going on in the world. Now, listen to this. I sort of categorize this stuff because I've interviewed about 700 to 1,000 people who are living off the new economy, starting new jobs, starting new businesses, creating new jobs for themselves and everything, all on the internet and getting money to do that. You know, and that's what he's doing. Now, really, like, the epitome is that he is living in the gig economy. It's not like he just woke up and said, hey, I want to do a new job for a while, you know? Instead of having one job forever, that's how we're really starting to live more and more. One gig and then another gig and then another gig, you know? So he's doing that. I mean, waking up one day and saying, hey, I think I'll be president for a while. That'll keep me busy for a couple of years, right? Yeah. So that's it. He is really epitomizing the gig economy. And also what he's showing us is that you don't need credentials to do what you want to do in life anymore. You know, I mean, the guy wasn't even mayor or a governor or even ran for city council. No credentials in what he wants to do. Just decided to go out and try to do it. And that's what I see in all the entrepreneurs and the other people that I'm interviewing. Man, they don't have backgrounds in any of the talents, even, you know, the talents that are required to do, even to invent products, to raise money, to do things that they even have no technical expertise in it. They just get it somewhere, you know, and for very little cost and just make it happen. So that's what he's doing. He's showing you, yep, you don't need credentials to do what you want to do in life. Yep. And also, this is an important thing, you don't need money. He's succeeding without money. You know, it's 6 months into the campaign, yeah, and he still hasn't spent a nickel on advertising. And I don't think anybody wants to work for president particularly. Man, you need a big war chest to spend all this advertising money on. Like all the other guys, like Jeb Bush, meant tens of millions of dollars, you know, that went nowhere and all got him less in the polls. You know? He hasn't spent a nickel. See, and that's how entrepreneurs are doing. They're not spending money, you know, on developing the products. They develop the idea of the product, and then they get money on the internet to do the product or advertising. No, all social media, and that's free advertising. You just have to learn that system to do it. It doesn't cost money. It just takes time and effort, you know, to learn the system. So that's why, you know, Trump is doing it the new way. All the other guys in the race are stuck in the old stuff, you know, and that's why they're being left behind. And also, listen to this, he's creating his own opportunity. He's not waiting for somebody else or hooking on to somebody else's opportunity or whatever. He's creating his own. And that's what I see these people are using the new internet economy. They create their own ideas. Man, this is the way things should be, you know, and you don't need money and stuff to do it, so I'll just go out and do it myself, you know. And that's what he's doing. And I think that's where we're going now. This is what our life is all about, you know, and that's where the people are that are really moving and shaking things, you know? Also, it's the establishment no longer has control of everything, right? So he doesn't even care about the Republican National Committee or whatever, you know, he's just doing his own thing. I'll run on you guys or somebody else or his independent, doesn't matter, you know? So the establishments like that used to run everything and now they don't, yeah. You know? They don't have control. They've lost control. I mean, if you want to write a book nowadays, you know, when I did that writing book, I had to go to New York and all these publishers, no, you just go on the internet and do it. And you raise money on the internet from future customers that give you money to write the book. You know, things like that. Or you want to start a business. No, you use crowdfunding, raise money from potential customers in the future. You don't even have a product yet and you're getting money. The fat cats are out. You know, the bankers, the venture capitalists and things like that, all the people that are running on the levers, man, they're shrinking because there's a way to do it for anybody. Just like Trump's showing us that. man, he's not using the established system. Everybody thinks that, oh, there's only one way to do it. Nonsense. Yeah, there isn't. Now there's so many ways, nobody could count them. There's a way, a different way for everybody to do it. Also, the experts are wrong. I mean, this obviously. I mean, you look at 6 months ago, man, when he started out, people say he'd be gone in 6 weeks, right? That sucker's still there and getting bigger numbers than ever, right? Now, all these experts who are writing articles about, oh, you know, these people have been following politics for 30 years, you know, oh, this couldn't happen. And now they're scratching their head, trying to figure out how the hell could I not look too foolish and admit I was wrong. And that's true about everything nowadays, I think. The experts don't know. They're guessing. Everything in our world is changing so quickly. Anybody who's been studying yesterday, it's going to be wrong because yesterday don't work no more. So you can't, there's no way to study yesterday to figure out what's going to happen tomorrow. You just got to do it and take a chance and see what the hell happens. And now you can do things without risking money or anything. And so if that doesn't work, you try another way. Yeah, and that's what's the, I mean, particularly in crowdfunding and things like that. 5 years ago, you know, who would have said that you could have a hotel chain with a million rooms and have nothing but a website? That's right. That's what Airbnb is. A million rooms. They're worth more than Hyatt Hotel. And they've been around for 5 years and they have more rooms available, but they don't own a single room. They just have a website, you know, and they're worth like $50 billion. Who would have said that, you know, that would work 5 years ago? And that's all they've been. Or how about Uber, the taxi service people? Man, in 5 years, they're now have more, they're bigger than Hertz and Avis together and own no cars. All they have is a website. And they're worth 10 times, you know, or 5 times or whatever, a lot more than Hertz and Avis together, you know, the value of that company. So that's why you can't. Experts don't know what's going on nowadays. You can't, like, even I've seen, I do a lot of crowdfunding thing. What's happening on crowdfunding? Man, somebody just got $50,000 from thousands of people to taste this potato salad. Taste the potato salad. Now there's about 100, 200 people now who are raising money to be the next potato salad entrepreneur or whatever. Who would have thought? You know, you can't. And that's why, you know, you take your heart and you put it out there, and there's tools in our society to do that. And that's what Trump, to me, is so valuable, to show, hey, the old stuff doesn't work anymore. And that's what it is. And also, I mean, this epitomizes it. No matter what you do in life, you know, if you really want to do something, you're probably going to piss somebody off. He's pissing off, you know, who's it? Besides John McCain, you know, calling him a draft dodger or something like that. He wasn't really a hero. I don't know, something like that. But also the Latinos and women and Muslims, you know. Oh, he's pissing off these people. Now, maybe an idiot for doing that. But, you know, even not being an idiot, you're going to piss off somebody, you know. Because change, that's what happens, you know. See, you can't please everybody if you want to do something new. Because if you're trying to please everybody, that means you're going to do the same old thing. Because nobody, the people who get pissed are the people who don't want change, right? So if you're trying to change something new, you're going to piss somebody off, right? And if you're trying to not, you know, make everybody, if you're trying to make everybody happy, you're not going to do anything new. And it doesn't have a chance to grab something new that's the future, instead of fighting for old peanuts left by the last generation or whatever heck is shrinking and not growing. So it's that. I mean, if you're going to change the status quo, you have something, you know, boy, you just can't please everybody. Remember that. And the other thing, I think the most important thing about what he does, I think, for people now is to show, even if he doesn't win, man, you could tell he's having fun. So win or lose, man, he's having fun every day doing this, isn't he? And I think that's the key, man. So in anything we do, we have no idea we're going to win or lose, or your business is going to do, or something is going to happen. But if you're having fun, man, and then you won. You won already because you're having fun every day. And you see Trump, man, he's like the Cheshire Cat every day. Yeah, whether he's being an idiot or just trying to be sensible, you could tell that sucker's having fun. So that's what I think life is all about nowadays, because nobody knows who's going to win. Nobody knows what the future is, you know, and it's all up in the air nowadays. So you get out there and start having fun, because nobody knows what's going to work anyway. And so you take your heart and just do the things you really want to do, like he's doing. And you're having fun. And who cares if you win or lose? Because every day you're waking up having fun.